This is Tim. Tim is an anatomy student. He's been studying really hard for his upcoming exams. The problem is none of the information is sticking, and he feels like he hasn't made any progress from one revision session to the next. He can't seem to remember anything he learned yesterday, let alone last week. And he's even fallen asleep a couple of times, head buried deep in a 100-page chapter of his anatomy textbook. The truth is, Tim is frustrated. He thought he was doing so well, but his efforts seem to be leading him nowhere. So where is he going wrong? How can Tim learn to study smarter and finally be able to remember everything he needs to know to ace his anatomy exam? Well, let's have a look at how he has been studying. Tim avoided revising for a long time before finally getting down to work. Now he only has 3 weeks until his exam and he's panicking. How did it come to this? Well, the problem is that Tim was viewing his impending revision as a huge and impossible task. Well, these feelings were uncomfortable, so he neglected facing up to them, resulting in not enough time to tackle his workload once he finally got down to it. What could he have done to avoid this? Quite simply, stop procrastinating. We know what you're thinking, that's easier said than done. We get it. But that's why it's important to have an anti-procrastination action plan ready for whenever you feel yourself getting sucked into the procrastination vortex. If Tim divided his workload into more manageable chunks, rewarded himself each time he managed to overcome a difficult hurdle, and created positive associations with the material he needs to revise, then his approach to studying would increase his chances of success tenfold. Because Tim has left his revision so late and is panicking about how much material he has to cover in such a short time, he has resorted to cramming. And as a result, Tim ends up not learning anything at all. Oh, Tim. So what's the solution? Well, simply put, Tim needs to be wise not to let his short-term memory fool him. Spaced repetition is the best technique for him, and for you. By allowing a few hours, if not days, between repetition of previously learned information, Tim will have to really think about and engage with what he has learned, which will result in better memory retention over time. As you have already learned, Tim is super stressed. He doesn't think he has time to repeat the information he has learned to himself after learning it. He thinks that the most effective plan is to stride ahead and cover as much as he can without taking a break. Unfortunately, Tim is on the wrong track. And what's the right track? We hear you ask. Well, the answer may surprise you. Research has shown that taking just 40 seconds to replay and describe in your mind the information you have just read or seen results in substantially higher recall. And there is an easier way, Tim. How does Tim actually read the information he needs to learn? He usually reads without stopping to reflect on the text until his head has collapsed into the book and he's snoring. When he wakes up, he doesn't remember anything, and the cycle continues. Happily for Tim, reading page to page in his way is unnecessary. Not only this, but it's ineffective. The best way to read effectively is to engage with the information. It's a surefire way to ace anatomy every time. Tim doesn't really think about how the information he has learned connects to his already existing web of knowledge. He just carries on storming through his textbooks without stopping to think about how seemingly unrelated topics may be linked together to enhance his understanding of the overarching topic. Clearly, Tim has never heard of mind maps, which we like to think as the Swiss Army knife of the brain. Exactly as the name implies, it is a map reflecting what is present inside your brain. Mind maps are an amazing way to connect and solidify anatomical principles and topics. If only Tim knew, he'd be understanding everything in no time. Tim finds studying anatomy really, really boring. He only sticks to one learning format, which is why he often finds himself waking up post-passing out with his head in a textbook. With such a lack of fun in his routine, Tim can't maintain the length and intensity of studying needed to learn everything he needs to. Dear Tim and everyone watching this video, there is another way. Possibilities do exist to make your learning different, fun, and enjoyable. Using a collection of games, quizzes, and other learning formats allows you to maintain interest and enjoyment in what you are studying, setting you up for success in the long run. Learning in black and white is a no-no if you're looking to optimize your understanding of anatomy. And unfortunately, Tim hasn't incorporated any color into his revision at all. So what's the solution? Well, learning anatomy with a coloring book, of course. Yes, we know what you're thinking. Coloring books are for children, right? Well, no. Coloring books can be a fantastic way to help you to associate structure with function and help you memorize anatomical structures in an easy and fun way. Go on, try it. You don't know what you've been missing. The question is, are you like Tim? Have you been studying anatomy all wrong too? If so, you're not alone. Here at Kenhub, we specialize in helping confused anatomy students to master this subject. You may have finished this video feeling that you still haven't fully grasped how to put each of these top study tips into action. The truth is, if we were to give you all of our tips in one video, you'd be watching it all day. That's why we've compiled all these proven to be effective tips into a must-have ultimate anatomy study guide ebook. If you have been struggling to learn anatomy effectively, then this ebook is going to really help you out. Oh, and did we mention that it's completely and utterly free? To get a copy, simply register with Kenhub using the link in the description box below, or visit our website at kenhub.com. And that's it! The ebook will be sent straight to your inbox. Once you've got your ultimate study guide ebook, comment below with a book emoji. As always, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel, and of course check out our huge library of articles, videos, quizzes, and anatomy atlas over at kenhub.com. I'll see you there.